It's a good thing Colorverse makes some amazing inks, because I'm going to be cleaning this one out of my keyboard for months to come. So yeah, like I mentioned in the cold open, I ended up spilling some of the companion bottle while setting up for this video. Not only is it going to take a bit for the ink to come completely off my fingers, but I'm pretty sure that I'm going to be finding shimmer particles in my keyboard for quite a while. Anyways, that aside, today we're going to be taking a look at two inks from the Season 7 Eye of the Universe from Colorverse. The larger 65mm bottle of Extreme Deep Field, and the smaller 15mm bottle of NGC 1850. Now, we're going to nerd out here for a second, so if you want to look at the ink, I would suggest skipping ahead maybe about a minute or two. Now, for the nerds, these two inks are named for a pair of interesting bits of universal existence. The first one, XDF, is named for the Hubble Extreme Deep Field. The XDF is a 10-year project of stitching photographs to create a composite showing about 5,500 galaxies. Let that sink in for a second. 5,500 galaxies. Not just stars, galaxies. How this all ties into the ink, though, is that Colorverse created this one to be a nice deep blue-black that has a redshift that is reminiscent of the most distant galaxies ever seen. Given how long light takes to travel in the grand scheme of things, that means we're looking at light projected out from 13.2 billion years ago. So where does NGC 1850 fit in? Well, I honestly don't know, because I didn't reach out to Colorverse for their reasoning, but I would like to see these inks as a universal dichotomy, where XDF represents some of the oldest bits of the universe that we can observe, NGC is an oddball due to being a globular cluster of relatively young stars. The main portion of the cluster is itself only about 100 million years old. And as a pairing, I really like what these two accomplish together. On paper, XDF is just that, a deep, dark color. And when you put NGC on paper, you get a healthy shimmer and a brighter shade of blue. Do I think the pairing is worth $30 MSRP? Well, I mean, if I can get over the aggravation of a spill on my desk, then yeah, it is. Once again, I mean, I think Colorverse has made a pairing that I think provides a good value to quantity. So now that we've gotten past that, let's take a look at the unboxing. Now, I've already opened the box so I could spend a week with these inks before doing the review, but both bottles came in this rather robust box and are sealed with the season and color sticker of what you have as the contents. Once we open up the box, we're greeted with some literature on the season of the ink and, on the right flap, a little bit of caution. Do not use for purposes other than writing. Ink dries quickly. As you can see here on both Rodia and Tomoe, we were about at the 22nd mark, so, I mean, that's not exactly quick. Anyways, close the cap, keep away from kids, do not eat, you know, the usual warnings. On the left side, we have a space taxi, and now we can get to the literature. I will say this is one of those things that I think helps set Colorverse apart from their competitors. I mean, how many other companies are you going to see provide the RGB, hex, and Pantone values, as well as the surface tension and pH value of the ink? Don't get me wrong, this is extremely overkill, but I think it's that little extra touch that adds to the value of these inks. Moving past that, we have the included ink napkin, stickers, and do-it-yourself pen holder. And finally, the part we're here for, the ink itself. I don't know what it is about these teardrop bottles, but I still prefer them over the 30mm bottles, and for some reason, still find them to be some of the best bottles out there, at least in the looks department. We aren't here for the bottles though, so let's take a look at the ink. On the left, we've got the glistening NGC 1850. The lighter portions have a nice deep teal to them, but from the top down, the shimmer really is lost in the camera. Not so much on the left though. The more I look at this left blot, the more I'm getting Emerald of Shavor vibes. I'm not 100% on the color of the particles in the EOC, but I think it's pretty close. Long and short of it though, I like the combination of blues and greens of the transition tones, and I think that the sheen is a nice complement to the shimmer that we have on display. Moving over to the right, while the primary tones are still teal in nature, this set definitely fades further over into the blue territory. I mean, XDF isn't supposed to be a showy ink, and I think it succeeds in that. Just from the swab, it's easy to see that this ink is going to sheen. And no, I don't consider that to be showy per se, just a nice application of the darker ranges of an ink. While on the right, we have a nice suede blue in the mids with no sheen. On the left, we have a nice deep field of darker suede blue that brings in just the right amount of transition into red. Moving past the ink blots, let's take a look at the water performance and then take a look at the writing samples. The second I put water on the page, you can see the blue lift. Normally, if I saw this much lift on an ink, I would expect nothing to be left on the page, but these two actually held up quite well. To be fair, the blue lift did end up staining the page underneath, but what we're left with is easily recoverable and a very nice performance from both of these inks. So let's see how they look coming out of a pen. We're gonna start off with Tomoe. On both this and Rhodia, I'm gonna be bouncing back and forth between each pen. So while I do that, I'm just gonna go through some of my observations about each ink. For this writing sample, I'm using the Lamy Aeon with a medium nib, and over on NGC, we're using the Kaweco AL Sport with a double broad. My logic on this one was that I knew XDF had enough sheening potential that it should show out of a medium or finer, and I really wanted to reserve the wide nib for the glistening ink to make sure that the particulates can actually make it out of the pen. I'm honestly happy with my choice. You can see here that on Tomoe, our samples from the Lamy are immediately on the darker side of the blue shade and hitting the sheen with no effort at all. And we can see that the double broad of the Kaweco was the right choice as well. I'm getting a nice deep teal that has a healthy amount of shimmer and occasionally flirts with a subtle sheen. Now let's take a look at how it performs over on Rhodia. XDF is a little bit more subdued, with the overall tone being deeper, but not as much sheen on display. I don't know why, but I actually find myself slightly disappointed by this. NGC, however, is not letting up. If anything, we're definitely seeing more shimmer on display with Rhodia, and the ink holds more to the transition tones while still flirting with the sheen. Overall though, I find myself liking these two on Tomoe a lot more than on Rhodia, but as it is, they perform fairly well on both, and I think that if you like sheen and shimmer, then these two inks are a good addition to any collection. And that's gonna do it for Extreme Deep Field and NGC 1850 from Colorverse. Thank you to Pen Chalet for providing these two inks for review. Thank you guys to watching till the end. And if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you're one of the people that isn't, and click on the Patreon link to support the channel if that's your thing. Till next video, don't drink the ink.